Good day, children. Today, we are going to learn a new topic, that is factors and multiples. Today's subtopic is factors. At the end of the session, you will be able to write factors of given number. Here, let me start this factors with a short activity. As you can see, there are yellow coins. In all together, there are 10 yellow coins. If I ask you to arrange it in a proper order, say in a row of 1, you would arrange it as follows. This states 1 when multiplied by 10 results to 10. Same way, if I ask you to arrange in the order of 2, yes, 2 in an order of 5 columns, that is 2 5s are 10. Let us check with 3. We cannot arrange since 1 is left out. So 10 we cannot completely divide by 3. Let us try with 4. Again we see 2 are extra when we divide. Very correct. Let us try with 5. Yes, 5 exactly we can divide 10. That is 5 2s are 10. Same way, 10 1s are 5. But we are not able to divide 10 by 6, 7, 8 or 9. What this signifies? Yes, factors are also called as divisors. So here we would be finding the divisors of a given number, that are, what are the possibilities of a given number to be divided. So let us try with some examples. As you can see here, the question is to write factors of 16. Factors of 16 means you will note what are the divisors. That is 1. 16s are 16. Okay, let us try. After 1 we have a digit 2. 2 8s are 16. Right? 3. Can we divide 16 by 3? No. Let us go ahead with question, that is the digit 4. 4 4s are 16. So here we state 1, 2, 4, 8, 16 are the divisors, that is they are factors of 16. Always note that factors are ranging from 1 to the given number. So we have noted in a range like 1, how much are 16? Yes, 16s are. We go ahead with the next digit 2, 8s are 16, 4, 4s are 16. This states these all numbers which we receive, they are factors. So let us note down 1, 2, 4 and 16 are the factors of given number. Let us try with one more example. Let us write factors of 48. Yes, same way a tree diagram I have drawn. This states helpful for you to range. So let us start with 1. 1, 48 is a 48. How about 2? We can check by dividing 48 by 2. 2 twos are 4. 0, bring down the next digit. 2 fours are 8. That results to 0. Yes, 48 is completely divisible by 2. That is 2 24s are. Let us check with 3. Again, divide 48 by 3. 3 ones are 3, followed by 8. 3 sixes are 18. We have 3 sixteens are 48. Let us try one more. 4. Yes, 4 twelves are 48. Can we divide 48 by 5? No. 6 eights are 48. Can we divide 48 by 7? No. How about next digit 8? Yes. Now you could see all the data are ranging as same. The states we have noted all the divisors, that is all the factors of 48. Let us note down 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, 16, 24, 48. Kindly note, using this method, you will be having very less chances of missing of any of the factors. Let us check with a 3-digit number. How to find factors of a 3-digit number? Let us find factors of 124. Yes, we start with 1. 1 124s are. Can we divide 124 by 2? Yes, let us divide 124 by 2. 2 6 are 12. 4 2 2s are 4. So we now write 2 62s are 124. Can we divide 124 by 3? Not possible. You can even verify by actual division. 3 4s are 12. 4 1 3 1s are 3. 1 is the remainder. Let us check with another digit, that is 4. Yes, 4 31s are 124. This way we write factors of 124 as 1, 2, 4, 31, 62, 124. Here you can note that we don't have any other factors lying between 4 and 31. This concludes that factors always range from 1 to the given number. So in this class, we have learned how to frame factors of a given number. Always have key steps for noting whether the number is divisible or not. Like, if you check with 2, check that the unit's place or the last digit should be an even number. Like, we have here 124. So we could make out that yes, it is divisible by 2. 3, check again for 3. If you add all the digits, it should result to the multiple of 3. Let us see. 1 plus 2 plus 4, that is 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 4, 7. As 7 is not a multiple of 3, so we cannot go ahead. Same way, we have for 5. Check with the units and digits place. That is 0 and 5. We shall meet in the next class. Till then, take care. Goodbye.